Hello, so today we're going to look at tuples in Python. They're similar to lists, if you're familiar with lists. Tuples are immutable, it means you can't change them. There's a benefit to this, however, in that they use less memory, so they're more memory efficient. So let's just create a tuple called pets, so equals cat, mouse, monkey. And you can access the elements of it using the index just the same as you would with a list. So element number one should give us mouse. There we go, because the indexing starts at zero. Just to show that if you want to access the end of it, then you would just do something like minus one, and that should give you monkey. There we go. What we're going to look at in future is named tuples, but just to carry on with these here, what you can actually do is you can add two tuples. So let's create another tuple called zoo and equals crocodile and zebra. And then if we do zoo plus pets, there we see we've got crocodile, zebra, cat, mouse, monkey. And they stay in the same order. So you can always access them from using the index. They don't move about, not like a Python dictionary, for instance. In future, we will look at how you can convert a name tuple to a Python dictionary. But for now, this is all I wanted to show. One last thing is if you want to actually just check that the check the memory address, you just do ID. So if we do ID of pets, and if we do the ID of zoo, you see it's different. I know they both end in 08, but you've got 7408 there and you've got 9008 there. So why might you want to use them? Well, they're immutable, so you can be sure they're not going to be altered. So we'll do from collections, can't type, import name, sorry, plural. And then what we would say is we will say, let's do employee equals named tuple, and then employee. And we'll add a list and we'll just say name, age, salary, close that. And then what we will do is we will create effectively, it's a bit like the class, so we'll create a person called Bob, and then we'll say Bob equals employee, and then we'll load in the values. So we'll say Bob, 40, 34, and 45,000. There we go. So we've loaded up the values now. So if we want to access the values, then we can simply do something like this, which we could just say Bob dot name, we get, if we do Bob dot age. So you can see, rather than accessing a list via the index, the index of the element, you can actually call it from an actual name. So that's actually a lot easier to understand. So we'll do Bob dot salary. Good. So, and I said it's immutable, but we can actually do something like Bob dot underscore replace, and then we can say salary, and we'll say equals, because it's the key, we'll just say salary equals 55,000. And there we go, we've updated it. So although it's immutable, you can still update it, which is, I know that's a bit confusing, but what it's actually doing is it's creating a new tuple. So it's destroyed the old one. So yeah, that's how to update a tuple. And let's just see if we can work out how to change it to a dictionary. So we will do this. So we'll do Bob dot underscore as dict. And we now have it as a Python dictionary. So that was quite painless, wasn't it? And then we can obviously access it in the traditional way. So we'll say Bob dot name, Bob dot age, Bob dot salary. And now we have it. So